सत्कार प्रभो
Dr. Karan Singh Ji, our IWFA patron, Shri Kapil Sibal Ji, Mr. Sudhir Makkar, the Sibal family, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to 2020 18th IWFA Nina Sibal Memorial Award presentation. Tearing away from tradition, function is being held in the shadow of the COVID-19 pandemic. And these limiting circumstances have compelled us to hold a virtual tribute to commemorate Mrs. Nina Sibal's birth anniversary. This award is an integral component of IWFA's annual calendar, a very poignant experience which the organization cherishes as a labor of love, affection, and attachment. This function, we also have an opportunity to take stock of our work for the vulnerable sections of society. In this, which is also the 91st foundation year of IWFA, which was founded in 1929. Building upon the success of Khadi Goes Global, empowerment of rural women in the 2030 Agenda for Development, IWFA's delegation at the United Nations presented Khadi as a zero carbon fabric that has the potential to provide employment to rural women in the comfort of their homes. In partnership with the Khadi and Village Industries Commission, KVIC, the Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, MSME, the Permanent Mission of India at the United Nations, and leading designers, we IWFA generated awareness through the spinning wheel, the charkhas installations, block printing, demonstrations, films, publicity, panel discussions, exhibitions, fashion shows, and designer khadi prathawe. This was followed by a two-day national Northeast Expo to showcase the culture and spirit of the 8 states through panel discussions, meetings, art, culture, wood stalls, handlooms, and handicraft stalls. Earlier this year, on 2nd March 2020, the 64th session of the Commission on Status of Women was to take place at the United Nations headquarters. It was called off at very short notice on the 2nd of March because of the pandemic. All forum events were cancelled, including IBOPA's parallel event scheduled to take place on the 9th of March, Women's Education, Employment, and Economic Empowerment, and Accelerated Growth since Beijing. This intense preparation for the cancelled UN event helped IBOPA to be amongst the first few organizations to recognize and respond to the disastrous effects of the COVID-19 on the implementation of the Sustainable Development Goals. More so, as this decade from 2020 to 2030 was flagged worldwide as the decade for growth to achieve the SDGs. Overcoming the paralysis created by the coronavirus, IBOPA took it as an opportunity. Bilingual videos were created and disseminated on safety measures, a backpack of emergencies, impact on the elders, infodemic, and on counting our blessings. Then, in June 2020, recognizing that people with disabilities would be the hardest hit during this health crisis, IBOPA held a series of four webinars, Sustainable Solutions for Persons with Disabilities. These action-packed dialogues on the organizational impact of the COVID-19 pandemic were held with the previous awardees of the Nina Sibbal Award. We invited them to share their experiential learning on how people with diverse disabilities were impacted, organizational steps taken by them to build the resilience of the beneficiaries to cope with the pandemic, actions to integrate them in the policy framework during crisis situations, and best practices which could be upscaled and replicated. The webinars were on research and education, educational rehabilitation and outreach, visual impairment, and mental health. Following shortly is an international webinar series on another vulnerable group that demands an even greater intervention, the elders. Although the preparations for holding the webinar series are complete, implementation is taking time as we are in the process of sourcing funds. So the webinar series, Sustainable Solutions for Persons with Disabilities Report, has been completed and printed with limited copies. An online version also follows soon. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Chandra, for the illuminating insights into the activities and achievements of IBOPA. I would now like to call upon Dr. Karan Singh, Mr. Kapil Sibbal, Mr. Sudhir Makkar, and Mrs. Asha Chandra to release the report of the IBOPA Nina Sibbal webinar series report. I would also request all the IBOPA executive committee members to keep their videos on and the audios off and release the report along with the dignitaries. Thank you, everyone. As you're all aware, the Nina Sibbal Memorial Award for the Differently Abled is awarded by IBOPA every year since the year 2002 with the invaluable support of Mr. Kapil Sibbal. I would now like to call upon Dr. Karan Singh, a man who needs no introduction, but I will still give him one. Philanthropist, poet, parliamentarian, a person who has served as the president and governor of Jammu and Kashmir, and more recently as the Chancellor of the Banaras Hindu University to share a few words and introduce the prestigious awards. So I'd like you to take the mic. Request you to unmute. Dr. Karan Singh.
Not hear me?
Yes, now we can hear you, sir.
All right, sorry. My friend and colleague, Dr. Sibyl, members of the Sibyl family, Srimati Asha Chandra, President AWEFA, Sarla Manchanda, convener of this award, and the awardee for this year, Mr. Prasenna Dhuni Nageshwara Rao, and other friends watching this webinar. When Kapil set up this award about 20 years ago, we had a meeting and we discussed what should be done, and we decided that instead of having a general award, we should give this award to persons with disabilities. Because at a conservative estimate, 5% of Indians, if not 10%, suffer from some disability, which runs into tens of crores of people. And that's a neglected area. So for 18 years now, this award has been given to people and organizations working in the field of disabilities, single disabilities like audio, visual, locomotive, and so on, or multiple disabilities. And AWEFA has done a fabulous job every year in taking the trouble to identify good organizations from around the country to whom this award can be given. Now, as you know, this award is in honor of Nina Sibyl, a remarkable woman, a writer, a diplomat, an administrator, a woman of great vivacity and courage. And all of us who came into contact with her will never forget her. My own interaction began when I was the Indian member of the governing board of UNESCO, and she was our permanent representative to UNESCO. And at her receptions, I was impressed to see the range of her contacts and the depth of her interaction with people in UNESCO and others. And she was really a poor woman. She fought till the end of her life. She had this life-threatening illness. She fought till the very end. And she was a great fighter, great woman. And therefore, it is fitting that we should meet every year to honor her memory. And Kapil has now raised the award to 8 lakhs. So I would welcome everybody here and hope that this excellent publication of AWEFA, I must congratulate AWEFA for the work that they are doing. They have done outstanding work in this field, and this volume that we released today, I'm sure will be of great use for those people who are directly or indirectly involved with disadvantaged people. I'm not sure whether the education policy has any special formulations for the disadvantaged. I hope they have, because they do need special care. And in this strange world in which we are now living, the virtual world, I love it, by the way, because I just have to sit at my desk. You don't have to go anywhere, just speak. But it's a very strange world in which we are living. And as has been rightly said, the elderly do require special consideration. So this award and this gathering and the work that AWEFA has done is all coming together today as we meet every year on the 2nd of August in India, in the Habitat Center, but this time in our rooms. And I'd like to congratulate AWEFA for the work that they're doing, and also congratulate the winner of this year's awards. My very warm greetings to all of you. Keep well and take care.
Thank you, Dr. Karan Singh, for your kind and encouraging words towards AWEFA, as well as your sharing your memories about Ms. Nina Sibyl, as well as for gracing the occasion today. Thank you very much. I would now like to request Mr. Sudhir Makkar, Senior Advocate, to share a few words and memories about the inimitable Ms. Nina Sibyl, the reason why we have gathered today.
Honorable Dr. Karan Singh, respected Mr. Sibyl and his family members, distinguished office bearers of IBEFA, the awardee, Mr. Karunanidhi, and other members of this distinguished gathering. I am truly honored to be asked to say a few words about Ms. Neena Sibyl, in whose memory this award has been instituted. Whatever I have known or read about Ms. Neena Sibyl, besides having a brilliant career as a diplomat, she was an author, a philanthropist, a social worker, and on top of everything, an extraordinary human being. She dedicated a large part of her time and energy working for the underprivileged. It doesn't happen very often that you come across somebody who leaves an indelible impression in your mind and memory. My memory of Mrs. Neena Sibyl dates back to almost 37 years. I had the good fortune of meeting and knowing Mrs. Neena Sibyl when I was doing my graduation in law from Campus Law Center, or Law Faculty as it is called in Delhi University. And that was in the years 1982 to 85. To my recollection, she was a bad junior to me, but she was senior enough in years and stature, as she was already an accomplished officer in the Indian Foreign Service when she joined Law Faculty, and that in fact in itself made her stand apart from the rest. She had an aura about her that couldn't go unnoticed. She carried herself with dignity, elegance, and grace that everyone and anyone studying or teaching at Law Faculty at that time was in awe of her, and for good reason. She was reserved by temperament, yet had a pleasant demeanor, was down to earth and amiable in her interactions, which endeared her to her peers and teachers alike. It's been 35 years since I passed out of Faculty of Law, but I still vividly remember her gentle face and demeanor. The students were in awe of her also for the reason that besides being an accomplished member of Foreign Service in her own right, she was the wife of Mr. Kapil Sibyl. And any student who had any serious aspiration of joining the legal profession at that time was quite familiar with the name of Mr. Kapil Sibyl even back then. Let me recount one of the instances which I still remember despite lapse of so many years. I still remember that she used to come to Law Faculty in her Fiat car, which she used to drive herself. In those days, not more than 3 or 4 students used to come in their personal cars. And these cars used to be parked within the Law Faculty compound. In fact, not many lecturers came in cars. One day, while Mrs. Sibyl was on her way out after attending lectures and was about to sit in her car, someone pointed out that there was a stray dog sitting under her car. While some other students would make sounds to shoo away the dog, like most of us do even today probably, she went to the canteen and came back with a packet of biscuits. Then she enticed the dog to come out from under the car, and having fed biscuits to the dog, she drove off while rest of us watched the scene with a mix of amazement and awe. This small incident only reflects the kindheartedness of the person in smallest of things. As Khalil Gibran has said, smallest of kindness is worth more than greatest of intentions. I also believe that sometimes miracles are good people with kind hearts. It is almost amazing how after 40 years I have come to know her family so well. When I joined the profession, I had the opportunity to interact with Mr. Kapil Sibyl, who is undoubtedly a stalwart in legal profession, our mentor and guide. Later in the years, I also got to know Mr. Amit Sibyl, as we were opposing each other in some of the matters, and over the years we bonded well, and he has become a very, very dear friend. It was in one of my interactions with him that I mentioned to him that his mother was also studying in law faculty at the same time while I was a student. I think that became a special connect between me and Amit, and we grew even closer. He's indeed a wonderful human being and a formidable opponent as a lawyer. His younger brother, Akhil, is an equally refined lawyer and is opposing me in more matters than I would want him to. I guess that's the charm of this profession. Inside the court, we are fierce opponents, and outside the court, we are part of this brotherhood. Nina Sibbal Memorial Award has been set up in her memory for helping organizations which are managing and educating disadvantaged children. As I understand, helping underprivileged children was a subject very close to her heart. Nothing could be a more fitting tribute to the kind and benevolent soul that Mrs. Sibbal was than to set up such an award. I am privileged to be one of those who knew this great human being, and I extend my best wishes to Mr. Kapil Sibbal and his family members for this wonderful endeavor. I also must express my gratitude for offering me this opportunity to say a few words on this occasion in the presence of this august gathering. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bakkar, for sharing your reminiscences about not only Nina Sibbal ji, but also Mr. Kapil Sibbal and his entire family. Yes. I now have the pleasure of calling upon the awardee of the prestigious 18th Nina Sibbal Memorial Award 2020 for the differently abled, the KDB Trust, Andhra Pradesh, who are getting this award in recognition of their services in uplifting the differently abled children in rural areas. Sir, through this award, IWFA and Mr. Kapil Sibbal recognize the vision of Mr. K. Nageshwar Rao, Trustee and Chief Functionary KDB Trust, in providing commendable service to the socially disadvantaged and differently abled children of rural areas. I would now like to call upon Mr. Rao to say a few words. Mr. Rao.
Namaste, Dr. Karan Singh ji. Namaste, Kapil Sibbal ji. Namaste, Makkal ji. Namaste, Asha Chandra madam, and other dignitaries. It's a great pleasure to receive this prestigious Nina Sibbal Award from a renowned NGO, IFA, working for the welfare of the mankind and for women empowerment for the last 91 years. I request, we have already sent a video there. I request you to play the video of KDB Trust activities.
మానసిక దివ్యాంగుల పాలిట వరంలా వెలిసింది కాశీనాథుని దుర్గాంబ బుచ్చయ్య చారిటబుల్ ట్రస్ట్. కృష్ణా జిల్లా పామర మండలం ఎలకుర్రులో 16 ఏళ్ల క్రితం వెలిసిన స్వచ్ఛంద సేవా సంస్థ మానసిక దివ్యాంగుల జీవితాలలో ఆత్మస్థైర్యం నింపుతోంది. ఉపాధి శిక్షణ తరగతులు, ఫిజియోథెరపీ సేవలు ఉచితంగా అందిస్తూ అందరి ప్రశంసలు అందుకుంటోంది.
సొంత గ్రామానికి సేవ చేయాలనుకున్న ప్రవాసాంధ్రుడు కాశీనాథుని సాంబశివరావు సంకల్పమే ఈ కేడిబి చారిటబుల్ ట్రస్ట్. సరిగా కూర్చోలేని, మాట్లాడలేని, తమ పనులు తామే చేసుకోలేని మానసిక దివ్యాంగులకు ఉచితంగా ఫిజియోథెరపీ, స్పీచ్ థెరపీ వంటి చికిత్సలు ఇక్కడ అందిస్తున్నారు. భవిష్యత్తులో ఒకరిపై ఆధారపడి జీవించకుండా వృత్తి విద్యా కోర్సుల్లో శిక్షణ ఇప్పిస్తున్నారు. తమకు ఇక్కడి శిక్షణా తరగతులు ఎంతగానో నచ్చాయని, తమలోని మార్పులు చూస్తూ వారి తల్లిదండ్రులు సంతోషిస్తున్నారని దివ్యాంగులు చెబుతున్నారు. తమ పిల్లలను సొంత బిడ్డలుగా ఆదరిస్తున్న కేడిబి ట్రస్ట్ నిర్వాహకులకు రుణపడి ఉంటామని వారి తల్లిదండ్రులు చెబుతున్నారు.
ఫ్రెండ్స్ పేర్లు చెప్పు రమ్య. శిరీష,
శిరక్క, అను, స్వాతి.
నేర్చుకుంటున్నాను ఫిజియోథెరపీ, చేయించుకుంటున్నాను
మమ్మీ
డాడీ
హ్యాపీగా హ్యాపీగా
ఉంటున్నారు
బంధువయ్యా. భద్రాచల రామయ్య రామ్ ఆదుతునే ప్రభుమయ్యోజ రామయ్య చైరోద్ధరించే వాదయ్య మా సీతారామయ్య రా చైరోద్ధరించే వాదయ్య మా సీతారామయ్య రా తోతెలు దీచే వాదయ్యరా తోదండ రామయ్య రా.
బాబు 2007లో పుట్టాడు సార్. పుడితే 3 సంవత్సరాలు ఉన్న తర్వాత వేరే స్పీచ్ డాక్టర్ చూపిస్తే స్పీచ్ థెరపీ అన్నారని వేరే స్కూల్లో విజయవాడలో తీసుకెళ్ళాం. వాళ్ళు గంటకి 100 200 అని చెప్పేవాళ్ళు. అట్లా 2 3 లక్షలు పాడు చేసేసాం. నెంబర్ 1 సార్, ఎందుకంటే ఇలాంటి సంస్థ డబ్బు తీసుకునే బోర్డులన్నీ ఉన్నాయి, కానీ ఇలా చేయటం అనేది చాలా గొప్పదనం. అసలు ఒక్క రూపాయి కూడా ఆశించుకోకుండా ఇలా చేస్తుంటే.
మేము ఒక నెల రోజుల నుంచి వస్తున్నామండి. అంతకుముందు మా బాబుకి బాగుండేది కాదు, నడవడం మాటలు రావు, ఏమి లేదు. ఇప్పుడు ఇక్కడికి వచ్చాక కొంచెం వాళ్ళు చెప్పే నేర్చుకున్నాడు. కళ్ళు ముక్కు బాడీ పార్ట్స్లో అన్నీ చెప్పారు, కొంచెం పర్వాలేదు, అన్నీ తెలుసు, అడిగితే చెప్తాడు మొత్తం.
సమాజంలో తోటి వారికి సహాయపడాలనే తలంపు చాలా మందికి ఉన్నా ఆ అవకాశాన్ని భగవంతుడు కొందరికే ఇస్తాడని ఇక్కడి శిక్షణ ఉపాధ్యాయులు ఆనందం వ్యక్తం చేస్తున్నారు. చుట్టుపక్కల గ్రామాల నుంచి సుమారు 60 మందికి పైగా పిల్లలు ఇక్కడ శిక్షణ పొందేందుకు వస్తుంటారని వారు తెలిపారు. థెరపీ, కంప్యూటర్, కల్చరల్ విభాగాల్లో క్లాసులు నిర్వహిస్తున్నారు. సేవాభావం కలిగిన ఈ ట్రస్టు ద్వారా ఉపాధి పొందుతూ దివ్యాంగ చిన్నారులకు సేవలందించడం సంతోషం కలిగిస్తుందని ఉపాధ్యాయులు చెప్తున్నారు.
శారీరకంగా ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఉన్నవాళ్ళు, సమస్యలు ఉన్నవాళ్ళు, తర్వాత మాట రాని వాళ్ళు పిల్లలు, తర్వాత బౌద్ధిక పరంగా కూడా తక్కువ మందబుద్ధి అట్లాంటి పిల్లలు, వీళ్ళకి కూడా ఇక్కడ ట్రైనింగ్ ఇస్తాం. ఈ ఆర్గనైజేషన్లో మనతో పాటడం నాకు చాలా గర్వంగా అనిపిస్తుందండి. తర్వాత ఈ ఫీల్డ్లో కూడా ఏంటంటే పిల్లలకి మనం ఒక ఇండిపెండెంట్గా చేసగలిగితే, వాళ్ళకి సొంతంగా వాళ్ళ పనులు, వాళ్ళ మాటలు మాట్లాడడం, వాళ్ళ ఇండిపెండెంట్గా చేయగలిగితే మనకి చాలా సంతోషంగా అనిపిస్తుంది.
ఈ పిల్లలకి ఏంటంటే సెల్ఫ్ హెల్ప్ స్కిల్స్, తనంతట తాను తినటం, తనంతట తాను మంచినీళ్ళు తాగటం, తనకి ఏమైనా అవసరాలుంటే చెప్పటం, ఇలాంటివన్నీ నేర్పిస్తామండి. తర్వాత స్పెషల్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అంటే వాళ్ళకి చిన్న చిన్న పదాలు, వాళ్ళ పేరు, అడ్రస్లు, డబ్బులు, కలర్స్ అవన్నీ నేర్పిస్తాం. బయటకి ఫంక్షన్స్కి వెళ్ళడానికి కూడా చాలామంది ఇబ్బంది పడతారు తల్లులు. అలాంటిది ఇప్పుడు ఈ పిల్లల్ని తీసుకుని వెళ్ళడానికి చాలా హ్యాపీగా వెళ్తున్నారు.
క్లాస్ రూమ్లో లెసన్స్ వైజ్గా చెప్పినప్పుడు కంటే ఇలా సిస్టంలో సమ్ నెంబర్స్ నేర్పించడం, ఏబిసిడీలు, ఆల్ఫాబెట్స్లు, ఇంకా ఎడిషన్స్ చేయడం, బొమ్మల ద్వారా నేర్పించడం, అలా త్వరగా అర్థమవుతుందని చెప్పి కంప్యూటర్ ద్వారా నేర్పించడం జరుగుతుంది. మామూలు పిల్లలతో కంటే 10,000తో పనిచేయడానికి కూడా చాలా బాగుంటుంది.
గత 16 ఏళ్లుగా ఎలాంటి లాభార్జన ఆశించకుండా ట్రస్ట్ ద్వారా సేవలందిస్తున్నామని సంస్థ నిర్వాహకులు కాశీనాథుని నాగేశ్వరరావు అన్నారు. నెలకు సుమారు 4 లక్షల రూపాయల వ్యయంతో నిర్వహిస్తున్న ఈ కేంద్రాలకు కొందరు ప్రముఖులు విరాళాలు అందించారన్నారు. సుమారు 130 మంది పిల్లలకు తమ శిక్షణా కేంద్రం ద్వారా సేవ చేయడం ఆత్మసంతృప్తిని కలిగిస్తుందని చెప్పారు.
ఈ సంస్థలో ఇంటలెక్చువల్ డిజేబుల్డ్ చిల్డ్రన్ సంబంధించినటువంటి ఫిజియోథెరపీ, స్పీచ్ థెరపీ, అలాగే స్పెషల్ ఎడ్యుకేటర్స్తో విద్యా నేర్పుతారు. అలాగే పెద్ద పిల్లలకి వొకేషనల్ ట్రైన్స్ అంటే రేపు పొద్దున ఏదైనా వృత్తి చేసుకునేందుకు వీలుగా ఉండేందుకు వీలుగా కొన్ని వృత్తుల్లో వాళ్ళకి ట్రైనింగ్ ఇవ్వటం జరుగుతుంది. అయితే మేము గమనించినంత వరకు తల్లిదండ్రులు కనుక ఎక్కువ కాలం ఈ పిల్లల్ని సంస్థకి తీసుకురాగలిగితే వారిలో మార్పు వచ్చేందుకు అవకాశం ఉందనేది మాత్రం మా పరిశీలనలో తేలుతోంది. స్వచ్ఛంద సేవా సంస్థ నడవాలంటే దాతలు కానీ లేదా ప్రభుత్వం కానీ సహాయం అందించకపోతే నడవడం చాలా కష్టం.
పుట్టుకతోనే తమలో వచ్చిన లోపాలు కూడా గుర్తించలేని మానసిక దివ్యాంగులు వీరంతా. అయితేనే తమ కాళ్లపై తాము నిలబడేందుకు ఎంతగానో సహకరిస్తున్న కాశీనాథుని దుర్గాంబ బుచ్చయ్య చారిటబుల్ ట్రస్ట్ నిర్వాహకుల శిక్షణతో తమ కాళ్లపై తాము నిలిచేందుకు శిక్షణ తీసుకుంటున్నారు. ఎంతో మంది ఇలాంటి మానసిక దివ్యాంగుల పాలిట వరంలా మారుతున్న కేడీబీ ట్రస్ట్ నిర్వాహకులు అభినందనీయులు, ఆదర్శవంతులని చెప్పాలి. కెమెరామెన్ నాగరాజుతో జయశంకర్, ఈటీవీ న్యూస్, పామర్రు.
KDB Trust is to improve the quality of life of different disabled children and families in the state of Andhra Pradesh. The mission of KDB Trust is to mainstream the different disabled children and to provide life skill training and equal opportunities to all different disabled children. We convey our heartfelt thanks on behalf of KDB management, staff and children to the managing committee of IFA for selecting our organization for this award. We specially thank Sri Kapil Sibbalji for instituting this award. During the crisis period of COVID-19, the KDB Trust is providing medicines as well as financial assistance to the children at their doorsteps. Apart from this,
the special teachers and physiotherapy doctors are providing classes through WhatsApp. The KDB Trust has three programs in near future. One is to start BED Special Education College in the field of intellectual disabled in Elakuru. Second one is to start special schools in tribal areas of coastal Andhra. The third one is to start shelter homes for intellectual disabled orphan women.
The video was indeed very inspiring, and we hope that the award will help you in taking all your activities forward. I would now like to call upon our very own Dr. Renu Malviya, Secretary IVFA and Associate Professor in the Department of Education at Lady Irwin College, University of Delhi, to read the citation of the award. Dr. Renu Malviya.
The citation. IVFA is pleased to present the 18th Nina Sibal Memorial Award 2020 to Kasinadhuni Durgamba Bhuchaiah Trust, KDB Trust, Andhra Pradesh, in recognition of their services in alleviating the difficulties of the differently abled children in rural areas. The KDB Trust, established in the year 2003, continues and extends the legacy of its parent school, founded in 1911, by working towards bridging the social divide. Operating from its 7,500 square feet premises, the trust governs three day schools in the area of Yelakuru, Machilipatnam, and Avanikatta. It also provides a pediatric clinic. The schools, reaching 130 children with challenges, provide facilities for physiotherapy, speech therapy, occupational therapy, and so on. The organization also offers a diploma in special education, intellectual disability, especially to train young women in that field. To carry forward the trust vision of an inclusive and equitable society. Recognition of its seminal contribution towards special and inclusive education, health and community integration of children with challenges in rural areas, the KDB Trust has previously been awarded a national award from the President of India in 2012. Through this award, IVFA recognizes the vision of Mr. K. Nageswar Rao, Trustee and Chief Functionary, KDB Trust, in providing doorstep services in rural India to the socially disadvantaged and differently abled children, thus enabling them to attain maximum independence, dignity, inclusion, and equal rights, as well as positions in society. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Malviya, for doing the honors. I would now like to request that the presentation of the award slides begin. Mr. Joshi, could you please begin the presentation of the award? I would request everybody to please give a round of applause for the wonderful award. Can I request Mr. Sibyl, Dr. Karan Singh, Mr. Nageshwar Rao, Mr. Makkar, and Mrs. Chandra to pose for a photograph?
How do we do that?
Yes.
Just smile. The rest will be done by IT.
Sure.
Mr. Joshi, can we move on?
No, wait a minute.
I think it has been done. I would like to congratulate Mr. Nageshwar Rao and the KDB Trust for receiving the prestigious award in recognition of their selfless service. On this note, I would like to call upon Mr. Kapil Sibyl, honorable member of the Rajya Sabha, senior advocate, poet, and a man without whose vision and support this award would not have been possible. So please say a few words.
Well, first of all, thank you very much for being here. This is a new medium through which we are interacting with each other. I must first of all thank Dr. Karan Singh. I remember way back in 2002 when I approached him. Without hesitation, he accepted to be part of the committee to manage set out the principles on the basis of which the awards were to be given. And you know, he's steadfastly been with us for the last 18 years. And I can't thank Dr. Karan Singh enough for being such a support in the memory of my late wife. I think he had an association with her which was very special. And when he used to go to UNESCO, I know for a fact that he used to interact with her and see her work. I also must thank IWAFA for having taken up this cause and allowed me to remember her every year on the 2nd of May on our birthday, and think about what my late wife really stood for. She was an absolutely amazing lady. And I thank you, IWAFA, for bringing back her memories every year on this very, very, very special occasion. Thank you very much, Asha Chandraji. Thank you very much, Ishani. Thank you very much, good friend Sudhir Makkar, for being here today and giving us some little snippet of your association with her. Thank you very much, Renuji, for reading the site. But most of all, I congratulate the KDB Trust. I congratulate Nageshwar Rao. I think the need of the hour is to actually go out in the rural areas where they do not have the kind of facilities that some of these organizations have in urban areas. And in that environment, to do the kind of work that you're doing is something that's novel. And congratulations for doing what you're doing and helping 130 children. And also trying to expand. You told us today that you are actually opening up 3 further programs, setting up shelter homes, in the tribal areas, doing some work in the tribal areas, and special education. You're making a start in special education, and the fact that you got a national award in 2012 itself shows the outreach of your organization. And so it's something that touches our heart when people like you go out and help your fellow human being. Dr. Manmohan Karan Singh mentioned about the new education policy, whether there are any reference to there is a reference, but I don't know how much in terms of implementation we will get in terms of this policy. I've been actually council for these young students who are now being forced to take examinations, after the pandemic and appear in these final examinations. And the kind of troubles that they are having to go through is unbelievable. Of course, we're trying to represent, I'm representing them in court, but many of them don't have the materials. Many of them, who are, say, visually disabled, one, don't have the course material. Number two, they need scribes to sit for the exam. And there are no scribes available in far-flung rural areas. And the centers that have been set up do not provide that facility. So I don't know how these people are going to take up the examination. I'm just giving you an idea of the kind of mindset that even universities have towards children suffering from disabilities. It's something that is very disturbing, because they are forcing them to take the exams when they don't have, many of them don't have materials with them, many of them don't have the facility of connectivity. And, for the mock tests that were held, about 8 to 9% could actually upload the answer papers. 90% could not. So I think the attitude of people has to change. I think you must also, we must all realize that we were born with disabilities. Disabilities is part of growing up. We were enabled by others. And those disabilities were taken care of. And many of us will pass away with disabilities, because of disabilities. So disabilities is part of being alive. And some of them suffer more, and some of us suffer less. But I don't think we should have a discriminatory attitude towards those who suffer more. I think it should be part of societal outreach in any inclusive state to reach out to those much more than others, to deal with and help them make life a happy event. And that's what KDB Trust is doing. And I congratulate KDB Trust for that. And I'm very happy to note that over the 18 years, we've been actually picking up organizations which have done yeoman work, and especially those who don't have too much cash and too much money. And that's very important. For those which are rich NGOs, which do a lot of work, even though they do very good work, we don't need to actually give them these awards. We need to give awards to those who do not have the finances and who do not have the resources. And I'm very happy that you chose KDB Trust, because which is in the far-flung areas, in rural areas. So thank you very much. And as usual, at the end of each little event on the 2nd of August, I read a little poem. And I have a little poem for you that that is a reflection of India of today as I see it. It also has some reflections about the kind of society we live in and the insensitivity of people around us. And it goes like this: Kiska sahara lo, kanun to hathiyar ban gaya hai. Kiska sahara lo, kanun to hathiyar ban gaya hai. Ab to shahar mein bekasoor bhi gunegar ban gaya hai. Ab to shahar mein bekasoor bhi gunegar ban gaya hai. Chal raha tha befikr hokar ghar ki sadak pe main. Chal raha tha befikr hokar ghar ki sadak pe main. उसी सड़क पे हिंसा एक त्योहार बन गया है. उसी सड़क पे हिंसा एक त्योहार बन गया है. हिफाजत करने वाले भीड़ में खोए दिखे. हिफाजत करने वाले भीड़ में खोए दिखे. कानून का रखवाला भी अब साहूकार बन गया है. कानून का रखवाला भी अब साहूकार बन गया है. इंसाफ कैसे मिले मुझे इस बात पे तू गौर कर. इंसाफ कैसे मिले मुझे इस बात पे तू गौर कर. गवाह मुकर के सरकारी पैरोकार बन गया है. गवाह मुकर के सरकारी पैरोकार बन गया है. खौफ में गुजर जाएगा कब्र तक रास्ता मेरा. खौफ में गुजर जाएगा कब्र तक रास्ता मेरा, तेरी नजर में मासूम भी शैतान बन गया है. दिस इज द सोसाइटी वी लिव इन एंड आई थिंक इट्स टाइम फॉर अस टू रियलाइज दैट वी आर टेम्पररी विजिटर्स ऑन दिस प्लेनेट एंड वी हैव अ टाइम स्लॉट एंड इन दैट टाइम स्लॉट we should, instead of reaching out for ourselves, reach out for others. I think that's the only way to be happy in the journey, in the short journey that we have on this planet. Thank you very much. And thank you very much. To my friend here and for participating in this event. Thank you very much, Dr. Karan Singh, and thank you very much, Ayawaka, for all this. Good evening and good night.
Thank you, Mr. Sibal, for sharing those really thought-provoking words with us. And I think each of us must do something at our end to make society more inclusive. I would now like to call upon Ms. Sarla Manchanda, convener, Nina Sibal Awards. A committee and IIWFA executive member. She has the honor of being a person who has been associated with IIWFA for the past 20 years. So that is really commendable for the work that she has done. I would like to call upon her to give the vote of thanks, please.
Please unmute. We can't hear you.
Sarla ji, please unmute.
There seem to be some technical issues. Can I ask Asha ji, can you do the vote of thanks, please?
Thank you, Dr. Karan Singh ji, for giving your time to IIWFA for so many years. We are very, very beholden to you. Thank you, Mr. Kapil Sibal. Thank you, you and your family, who have always encouraged IIWFA. Thank you, Mr. Makkar, for being with us today. And thank you, IIWFA team, and Mrs. Manchanda, and everybody for making this program a unique program, although it's been a virtual one. Please, may I request Dr. Karan Singh, Mr. Sibal Saab, and the awardee, Mr. Rao, and Mr. Makkar to stay on, because we would like to have a snapshot with all the executive of IIWFA. Thank you so much. And we look forward to having the program at the India Habitat Center next year. Thank you so much.
Hello. Can I be heard now?
Yes, you can. Now you can be heard.
But I think Asha has taken over and thanked everybody. Still, I want to, because I have prepared it. So I would like to say it. Respected Dr. Karan Singh ji, Shri Kapil Sibal ji, Mr. Sudhir Makkar, Mr. Nageshwara Rao, and all other dear friends. I am here to thank you all on behalf of IIWFA. You know, I won't let this opportunity to speak because I have been speaking for umpteen number of years. So it has become part of IIWFA is the dearest function I organize wholeheartedly every year, and I think I play a very important role in this. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Karan Singh ji, ex-MP Rajya Sabha and patron IIWFA, who got the organization the opportunity to organize this prestigious function for such a noble cause since 2003. He has always been the guiding spirit behind selecting the organization for the award. I thank him for so graciously presiding over this event. I can't thank enough Shri Kapil Sibal ji, without whose generosity the award as well as the event would not have been possible. He is very happy that IWFA is continuing this annual award giving tradition in spite of pandemic situation. Kapil ji's heart, as he himself also said, goes all out to do more and more for these special children, and he visualizes Indian youth to live happy and productive lives filled with love, harmony, and great mental and physical health. I very much thank Mr. Sudhir Makkar, who introduced her to Shrimati Nina Sibal's many qualities that she could not go unnoticed wherever she walked. And she had a very, very kind heart. She was very compassionate and sensitive towards the lesser privileged. My heartfelt thanks go to Mr. K. Nageshwara Rao, trustee and chief functionary of Kasina Duni Durgambaiya Bachuriya Trust, KDB Trust, as we call it in short, who has been working with full dedication and commitment since 2003 to alleviate difficulties of the differently abled children in rural areas of Andhra Pradesh. I thank Ms. Asha Chandra, President IWFA, and her complete team of other office bearers, executive members, and office staff to have worked tirelessly for the last couple of months. I especially thank the IWFA jury committee to study and analyze all the details received from the applicants to reach at the decision to choose the awardee organization. Others helped by tabulating the data, critically examining the audit and annual reports of the shortlisted organization. I'm trying to avoid taking names, otherwise the thanks note will go on unended. I highly appreciate the conceptualization of 4 Nina Sibal Award winners webinars on COVID-19 pandemic and lockdown by IWFA. The panelists were all former NSA awardees, as Mrs. Chandra has already told you. The reports on 4 webinars released today are an effort of IWFA office bearers and executive members who worked day and night to bring it out in such a short time. I thank Dr. Anupa Sidhu for permitting the students to work as interns for the event, and the beautiful invocation rendered by Dr. T.G. Rupa of Lady Irwin College. I'm thankful to Mr. Mithun Singh, Office Secretary, who has been a big support in making the event successful. Thus, IWFA carries forward the spirit of Ms. Nina. Thank you.
Sarlaji, I can tell you from my own side that no function complete in the Nina Sibal Award without you.
Absolutely. I also think that way. Thank you very much for recognizing this.
Can I request all the dignitaries, Dr. Karan Singh, Mr. Kapil Sibal, Mr. Makkar, Mr. Rao, to remain here. I would also request all the IWFA executive members to switch on their videos so that we can take a last photograph before we leave tonight. Joshi ji, photograph please. Thank you all for being part of this first virtual Nina Sibal Award ceremony. Thank you for taking out your time. Good evening and goodbye.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.